red card decision itself, and then obviously how you performed after.
You know, I was pretty close to the tackle. I was, wasn't surprised that they VAR'd it. I was obviously hoping they wouldn't, but they did, and when they went for it, I figured it was a good chance he was going to go. Yeah, it's a little disappointing, but going back to the last game, you know, it is what it is. I mean, the team, I thought, responded in a great way. It simplified the game for us. You know, we had one job at that point, and it wasn't about going to get the second. It was about locking it up, and I felt their guys, you know, defended the box extremely well. Everybody emptied their tank and gave everything they had. They were gritty. I thought we were more physical, a tougher mentality throughout the game. And that's something we've been asking a little bit, and they responded. You know, I thought some individual performances. Obviously, the guy next to me, you know, Fred, Kofi coming in and helping out, Chris Durkin coming in and doing a job. Fisher coming in and, again, being very selfless and working his tail off. You know, Ulysses kind of, you know, I think showed tonight what he's about. Steve Clark, he's a winner, and he's, you know, he's got an unbelievable personality, and I think he helped out in a big way as well tonight.
Steve, what kind of went into the quick start you guys had tonight, getting that goal in the first minute and kind of putting the pressure on early?
Yeah, obviously that was a perfect start for us. We wanted to come out flying, being physical and pressing them right away. We knew we were going to do that the first 10, 15 minutes. And obviously with Ulysses scoring that goal, it was huge for us. I mean, it was a perfect start for us. After that, I thought we dropped off a little bit and we could have kept the ball a little bit better. So that's something we're going to work on. But, you know, overall, just proud of the guys.
This is great, Steve, for the team. It's got to be a relief, right, to finally get the first victory, maybe alleviate some of the stress pressure?
Definitely. You know, the thought creeps in of, you know, not getting a win and, you know, what's going to happen. We're going to be on the road for a while. So, didn't want to say this was a must-win game, but it was huge for us. It was really important to boost our morale as the group because we've been putting in hard work in every game. You know, last game we were close. Couple games we've been close, but to get it here tonight in front of the fans, it was great.
We'll get you off my back for 2 weeks.
how much do you think it does for your group's confidence, not only to get those points, but to kind of be able to, you know, you kind of had a situation in Orlando that was very similar in the first weekend of the season, and you've had some other situations where you've been a bit on the wrong side of luck, to weather this adversity in the way you guys.
Yeah, it's an easy one to throw your hands up. Again, I'm proud of the way, you know, the group responded. It wasn't just the group on the field. It was the guys that came in. And you know, Durkin coming in at halftime in a game like that, it's not easy. I thought he did fantastic when he came in. Again, the game was pretty boiled down in that second half. You know, the roles of players were pretty clear, and we defended the box extremely well. But it's a relief. I'm not gonna lie. It's been a while, and it obviously builds, and you want to get the first 3 points because, as Steve said, there's been a lot of hard work. You know, you guys see the games and the losses, but you don't see the preseason and the time spent with each other and the amount of work we put in. To come out here and have this type of feeling. It's a hard league to get points in, especially with the road that we've been on since the beginning of the season. So it feels good. We're going to enjoy it for a few days and get back to work and get ready for a tour out west.
Did Moreno come off because of injury? Or?
You know, we figured he'd have about 60 in him. And, you know, that became 45. So I'll leave it at that. I don't know if, you know, things get a little tight and you get a little cautious. So we'll see how he responds from that. And, you know, the turf in retrospect, it's tough. It's tough on the body. So we'll see how he holds up.
Were Ricketts and Maddox, Maddox and Alstead, were they available?
Alstead was, neither of them were available, no. Alstead got whacked on Wednesday on the foot, a bruised foot, and then Maddox took a blow to the head in training and was out for a couple days. And but they're, him and Chris Adore are in concussion protocol and they'll be back. They're moving pretty well, so they should be in training in the next week at some time.
Given, you know, the way Steve Clark played, is he, you know, has he given you a really tough choice when Austin gets...
No question. I mean, he's given me a tough choice from the day, you know, he hit preseason. He's been you know, just as good as Danny throughout the preseason. And he was a little bit punished for familiarity, frankly. Right? You know, he's a character, and he's vocal, and he wants to play, and he wants to be to win every day. He raises the level of training. Sometimes it boils over, but that's what you get with a guy that wants to win and hates losing. And sometimes that personality the game needs. So, yeah, it'll be no different than what it's been up to this point. They'll continue to compete, and we'll continue to have two very good goalkeepers.